Okay, that is Silent Hill 2, Part 2. In the saga that Anthony hits me every freaking time I play. So yeah, while you're gone, I was doing some farming, you know, killing all the line figures, getting their soul, leveling up my little wood plank here. Look at the stance I can do now, huh? Yeah, I'm just kidding, it's a different game. I'll possibly play in the future. So yeah, we just killed the line figure. Scary guy, scary voice, ruined by this bad HD port. That's my radio on. This is your inventory screen. Small radio, miss static when monsters are nearby. It is on. Picture of my wife. She looks pretty, right? Photo of Mary. Or Marie, like freaking the dumbass freaking Mimi G said. This is when before she had the damn disease, basically. There's a note right here. Look at the letter. Basically what you saw in the front monologue. You didn't mess that up, so I'm happy for that. Got health drinks, they restore your health, wood plank, all that good stuff, you know. You can actually adjust the volume on the radio, which I find interesting, actually. It's a cool thing. Yeah, that's good enough. I think you could have customized the color of this, too, but I just... Why not? Why the fuck not, huh? For the options? That's fine. The brightness in this game is very dark. So even if I adjust it to the highest brightness, which I think I have it is, because I like playing games really brightly, so. Now stack on the radio. That's a line figure to let you know that people are around. One doesn't work. My controller did that to me. I'm still trying to get away, see? One thing it doesn't work with is the mannequins. You see later. The mannequins will stay still until you activate them, of course, and there they go. Now you notice how you write stuff on this map. I'm supposed to go to the park. But I'm not going to the park. I'm going to look around for some items, because people love watching that, right? Yeah. Okay. Try to run away. Come on, James. You can do it. Run, man. Yeah, so this is basically a run of me just looking around for stuff. There's another line figure. Going down Lindsay Street, so it's all the way down. Blood in the street telling you where to go, we already know about that though. Let's say it's down this street. And anything important comes around, his head will move towards it, which is pretty cool. They do that in the Resident Evil games too. Oh no! This for some reason, I can't get past. And they're gonna get me! Oh my god, they're eating him, and now they're gonna eat me! Oh! Notice he switches his head to where the enemy is, like you would in real life, so that's pretty cool, too. Go down here, see if there's anything special here. I just like look at stuff, too, because you always learn something new, like, after you play it for the first time. Gonzalez's Mexican restaurant. Kind of cool and stereotypical. Oh, he has to sell tacos? Haha. Trying to move, it's really hard. So he's looking over here, I guess. And when you find out later in this game, you just run past them. That's what I do usually. I mean, when you get the small corridors, I'm one of those where the true survival horror, so you gotta save your bullets and all that stuff, so it's all good. Is there a Happy Burger here? This is their food chain. Yeah, this in everyone. When you play the third one, which I want to play later on, there's an item here. First aid kit. Stronger than the health drink. Really useful. Not good as the end pool, but hey, whatever. See, we're already making progress. You know, we found a health kit. I'm doing good. My health bar is fine. My DPS is pretty good. I think I might have a chance to beat this game. There you go. Let's go down here, Saul. I should cut this out, but whatever. So yeah, I'm blocked again by these freaking... Do they use these for epidemics? Like disease? I think they do. See, some of these you can't go into. I'm actually trying to look for one thing now. I'm looking for one thing. It should be down here. There's a diner here. You can't go in. There might be something over here, though. Oh, James is dead. Dude, they're all playing with me over there. Like, oh, hey, can we join you? And they're like, nope. There's a car over there. It looks pretty cool. This is what I was looking for. So you can go in this thing. Yeah. Go in here as a save file. And I'm not going to save it here. What's the point? I'll just do it so I'll be marking the map, of course. I'm not going to save it, though. It'll be a waste of time, right? There's a note here. There's a memo line in there. I'm waiting at Bar Neely's. Neely's Bar, probably. Now, I'll explain to you what this means later. In a little bit, so. So that's on my map. That's where I'm going to go next. Maybe there's someone there. Maybe it's Marie. It's Mary, jackass. Yeah, this is, is this the night door? I think it's just, like, one, oh, never mind. It's one door you can't go until it's, like, nighttime. It actually has a pretty cool riddle on it. It's pretty cool. I'll probably describe stuff in this game. It's really cool. So now I'm going to go to Barney Lease. I said I was going to go through the whole town, but, it's going to bore the brakes off you guys. There's one thing I want to show you, though. I think it's, on Harris Street. Do that or that one, Martin Street. It's pretty cool. Nice try. So yeah, just skip all this thing, go to Bar Neely's. Even though it should be Neely's Bar, which irritates me. Cat Burger. Go straight down the street and we should be there. Cool. Oh, it's on Neely Street? So that's why they call it... Is it on Neely Street? Oh, okay, so that's why they call it Neely's Bar. Did he found the street? See, a lot of questions you can bring up there. I like that about this game, you know? It's different like that. And I know I probably missed, like, 8 health drink, and you're probably yelling at me, like, you're such an idiot, you're not doing enough damage, whatever. Most iconic part of this game, one of the most iconic sayings in here. You think you're gonna find somebody here? Too wrong. There it is. There was a hole here. Now it's gone. Alright, sorry. There was a hole here. It's gone now. Now it's gone? I don't know if they switched it. Or they probably did. There's a map here, and this is basically telling you all the little things on this map. Go here, go there, all that good stuff. So yeah. See how it's circled? That's going to be put on your map. So I'm supposed to go to Martin Street. And then you go to the apartments. You have to go to Martin Street first, though. But basically what this is basically telling you where the right way to go. That's all it is, really. You know, that's basically all it's saying. Like, if you don't know where to go, it basically guides you. If you go down Nathan's Avenue to, let's go to the other map. Go down Nathan's Avenue, just keep going down so it goes off to the Paleville, whatever. If you do that, then there actually is, like, a block and they tell you where to go. So it's basically a guide, even though you should pretty much know where to go. But I like it, though. Silent Hill 2 and Silent Hill 2 is awesome, so. Okay. This is my one little detour. There's actually one more, but we'll see if I find it. So yeah, you just go down here. Pretty sure it's on Harris Street. So I'm gonna take a left and see if we can go down here. So I'm pretty sure it's on Harris Street. It's the place I wanted to show everyone. Might even be down this street. I don't know. Notice the fog, just a wall. That's basically what it is. Yep, I know. I know I didn't miss the street. I know. Stop screaming at me. YouTube audience. Oh yeah, I forgot about these guys. They crawl when you hit them on the floor and you have to kill them on the floor. It's real annoying. It's scary too. And that just actually scared me. There's another one. Ah, there's another one. There's three. I'm actually on edge right now. This is the one I want to show you. They have all these notes. Dead body. There's a memo on the ground. Going to write everything that I've learned so far, maybe this will help you, blah blah blah, reading this is probably dead. Is this Neely? This is the guy we're at Neely's Bar? Yeah, so I saw this, I was scared. Found him on the ground. I saw those demons, they were there, I'm certain, but my friend says he didn't see anything. It's actually true about the town. If that's true, does that mean whatever I saw was an illusion? Whether that demon that is being human is real, blah, 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 hallucinations I dreamed up. I think I know sure is beyond hope. They're all right behind me, but the game stops with it, so. Seems to be attached by light. This is basically a guide during the town. Oh, shit. I was wrong. I was wrong. Ah! So basically, it just tells you what to do. Oh, come on, man. That. You wanna go? We're just thrilling combat, going around in circles. Okay. Now you can keep hitting them on the ground like that. Try to do really. So yeah, I'm gonna fight them. And those players relax. It's dangerous in the fire gun. They basically hear the gun come towards you like zombies. Run away, I love that one. It's like, ah, she was scary when I first saw it. I was like, oh god. Run away, run away, run away. That's basically the guy of the game, just run the fuck away. Alright, now I'm just gonna go start doing the game how it should be. Run, please, sir. Yeah, they have a spray attack. That's basically their old gist, they just spray you to death. It's pretty funny. Big J's. See Big J's junk? That'd be cool. I'm just supposed to go on Martin Street, which I'm going to now. Stop yelling at me, YouTube. So yeah, just running down the street talking about random stuff. Huh? How about that wrestling, huh? Yeah, I always talk about it, right? Oh yeah, John Cena's awesome. What that noise is roaches. Oh, okay. Roaches will attack you on normal, easy, just step on them. Actually, if you play hard mode, you actually run into stuff and he does an animation where he bumps into stuff. And you can't, when you hit stuff in the, doing this one. See how you can hit through it? You wouldn't be able to do that in hard mode. That's the difference between hard mode and action. It's just annoying. Scare of the year. Ah! I fucking jumped him if we sad that. Oh my god. You dumbass. Yeah, James, just don't look at him. Yeah. He has nothing to say about this body, too. That's why I always hate. Like, no, say something. Say something witty, like. I don't know. Is that ketchup? Or is that Chris's blood? Yeah, they're trying to get out of here. That's the key to the apartments. That's where we're going to next. That's basically the first part of the game. So basically, fuck the park until later. That's basically what this game does. And I love that. So yeah, just keep going down. There might be one popping up there. That's why I always get afraid about the cars. Like, what if one's under there? I'm like, oh, they wouldn't do that. This is an early game. They wouldn't be able to do that. Then they fucking do it, and I shit myself. It's shitting everywhere. Hey, how's it going? Yeah, so I just keep moving along, get into apartments, call it a day, get a little breather for you guys. Yeah, of course I am checking my map like a billion times, I know. But there's an item down here. Oh, look at that, stop sign works. I never noticed that. That's cool. This is just random. Oh, and there's a walk too. It'd be cool if like a zombie's walking, it's like, hey, that's our pyramid head. Hey, how's it going? I never noticed that. That was cool. My freaking Dark Soul moves are helping me here. There should be something down here, though. Oh. Wow, I'm stupid. Okay, stupid part of the day. It's early in the day. You see it's 2:34. It's not night. It's really early for me, so yeah. Work night shifts, so yeah. Run, James, please. Just this once. What's in here? Oh, paper. Or is that first aid? Oh, first aid. You'll need them later. Oh, wait, something else here? Oh, yeah, health drink. Sweet. What's that? Oh, bullets. Awesome. You'll need it later when you fight PH all the time. Everywhere. Oh, wait, that's homecoming? No, that's homecoming wanted to be. This one was under a car and I missed the scare. Oh, no. Run, James. It's your only hope. It's not this one? Yeah, it's the other one. We'll go over here. Pass this guy first. No. I like how he takes off, too. Like, when he runs at a slight pace regularly, but when he sees an enemy, he runs. I like that. It's something different. Unless my controller is just fucking off. Let me in! The zombies are out there. Yep, this is the apartments, first part of the game. So I can look around. Let's look around, why the fuck not? So trash chute here. Garbage, no use for that. Well, we'll see. Always got use for garbage. You turn a plunger into a ladle, just like Mr. Krabs did. Bad joke, I know. So you can't go on this door, but you can unlock it later, of course. When it says it's locked, you're able to open it. When it says the lock is broken and can't get open, obviously you can't go through it ever. You notice when you go in the apartment, every door is basically locked or that, so. That's the part where I'm going to get lost. We'll see. You all see. Dastards. Okay. This is where I'll end it for today. For a little bit. I'm going to play through later. I don't know. It's maybe a little shorter, maybe a little longer. I don't know, but let's get the map here first. This is the apartments. You can't see the map some of the times because you need a light. You get it later. Yeah, you notice he doesn't start with one. Why would he bring one? You know, people will be like, oh, he should have brought it with them. Well, why would he bring it? So, yeah. Part 2, all done. I know the last one's kind of abrupt, but thanks for watching. And we're off.